Major flood emergency is unfolding in the state's far north as the remnants of Cyclone Jasper dumps relentless heavy rain. Homes are inundated and major roads are cut. Residents tonight scrambling to reach higher ground as water reaches roofs.
Worse than Jasper's full force arrival, the ex-cyclone's tail still whipping the far north with a major flood disaster. Rescuers race towards Holloway's beach with floodwaters reaching roofs and panicked residents desperate to reach safety.
There was also a pregnant woman. She was 9 months pregnant with a two-year-old toddler floating on the mattress in the upstairs of their house with waters rising.
It was a race to escape Machin's Beach.
Oh, mate, I can just roll through the floodwaters here.
I love living in Machin's, eh?
The suburb surrounded.
House is flooded.
And boats the only way in or out. All that water put lives in danger at an animal refuge.
Good girl.
Homeless animals, homeless again.
Hooray, we emptied out the shelter.
At Ellis Beach, storm surge was the concern during Jasper. Now a bigger threat's coming from the opposite direction. Torrents of water racing down the mountains, through buildings and out to sea. No church today at Marillion on the Cassowary coast. No leaving the house either, or even the couch. Floodwaters over the floors at Silkwood, trapping families in homes in Innisfail. Just as the cyclone clean-up was starting, an overnight drenching made clear the system was far from finished. This is what half a metre of rain on already saturated ground looks like. An orange enemy threatens Parranella Park's old castles, drowned beneath water and mist. Nearby, 12 people, two dogs, one cat and two chickens were plucked to safety after Baker's Creek crept too close.
They aren't sure where to leave, but over time we encourage them to just jump in and get out because, you know, I've lived here 14 years and never seen it before in my life.
Good Samaritans taking to the streets by boat, searching for residents stranded in Mina Creek.
From 2 o'clock in the morning, they said they woke up and they could see the river rising.
Safer to leave than stay and face more rain, deciding not to take a risk, unlike so many others. At a known trouble spot, a ute is pulled out of floodwaters at a bridge impossible to cross.
We've had multiple evacuations and rescues overnight.
This is life-threatening events.
Emergency alerts for dangerous flooding were widespread.
Oh.
Nearly 600 millimetres of rain fell at Black Mountain between Port Douglas and Cairns, half a metre in 24 hours at Coranda on the Tablelands, and at least 300 mils in the major centres. Cairns Airport not immune, flights were cancelled. The airport closed this afternoon as floodwaters threatened the tarmac.
The situation is changing quite quickly and it's evolving quite quickly as well.
North of the city, this is the view from the only road into Yorkeys Knob. Just one suburb, now an island.
Welcome to Far North Queensland, flooding life.
South of Cairns, residents can't get home, stranded with trucks queued at Gordonvale.
Turn off into our street.
Access will be an issue. In Mareeba, flooding carved out an enormous chunk of bitumen.
People that were on the other side of the road are now stuck and have lost their water supply.
And the deluge is far from done.
The totals that we could see, 6 hourly, up to 300 millimetres, and in a 24-hour period we could see rainfall of up to 500 millimetres.
Warning of a repeat of today.
Never seen this much water.
In a region already awash. Cairns was meant to have its Christmas carols tonight. Instead, the city's nervously listening to the rain. Michelle Jensen, 7 News.